have drawback claimants, and claimants are usually the parties which are entitled to claim the drawback. And keep in mind there are various players, and by the time the product is exported, it went through the importer, it usually went through the manufacturer or some kind of merchandiser that sells and buys products and ships them overseas. And it went through the transportation of companies, intermediaries, middlemen, middlewomen, middle persons. And so even though one party may wear the same hat, the rest, you still must be mindful that there are different players involved. And because there are different players involved, you have to know who has a basic right to claim the drawback. So the starting point is to understand that the exporting party, the party who exports the product, is not the only party that can make that claim. It is also the party that destroys the product. Remember, the product does not have to be only exported. And I think when we spoke about the rejected merchandise drawback, we mentioned that part, that the product can also be destroyed to qualify for the refund of duties. So, and this may make sense, but sometimes you may not be able to export this stuff altogether because there is some kind of legal requirements. Let's say the product has been deemed as not safe. So you may not be able to export it out, or at least legally speaking, because it doesn't comply with various safety requirements. But you already brought it in and you paid the duty for, so it may not be a good idea for you to export it to other places. It may be just easier for you to destroy it and avoid those penalties as a part of agreement with various agencies, such as Consumer Product Safety Commission, for example. And this is a real thing. If those of you who go to the department stores like Walmart, let's say, will see that like there is a board, and there is always some kind of recall notices out there. And those recall notices relate to the safety requirements. And what happens to those products, right? I have seen some of those products destroyed. Because in part of the safety issue, so this stuff happens. All right, now, so let's take a look at the players. So we have several players. The chart specifies goes by the type, manufacturing, unused, and rejected, and goes by the player, right? So you have exporter, destroyer, manufacturer, producer, intermediate party, and importer, right? The default is. For any type of drawback, exporter and destroyer are the parties that are entitled to claim the drawback automatically. All the other parties, they kind of, so the gray shaded area means not applicable. All the other parties can be entitled to claim the product, but they have to get the assignment rights. All right. They have to get the assignment rights, and because of that, there is documentation requires that shows the demonstration. Remember that certificate of manufacturing delivery that I was talking about, which is no longer a requirement. So documentation must show the chain of custody, the transfer of title, and the right to an ability for the party who claims the drawback to be able to show the eligibility for the monies that the exporter or the destroyer has assigned to that particular party. All right, now, so importer is a default yes for the rejected merchandise drawback, and the reason for the rejected merchandise drawback is because it's usually the importing party who comes in and and remember, we talked about that sample specification requirement where you got the smiley face, but it was upside down. So, picking off on that example, it's not going to, the importer will usually be a grief party, and the importer will usually be the party who says, okay, I don't want this stuff, I'm shipping it back. So you importer, given the specificity of this rejected merchandise drawback situation, the importer would be usually the one that is also the acting as an exporter. In other cases, such as the manufacturing drawback, it would be the other way around. It would not be usually the importer, because the importer and manufacturer, although sometimes are the same, they are usually different parties. The blank shall be entitled to claim drawback unless this party, by means of certification, assigns the right to claim drawback to an intermediate party in the following scenario. So let's take a look at the scenario here. So you have company Alpha that imports CBP duty assessed graphite from a seller MNO in Australia. So we have Australia, and we have United States, and we have MNO, and we have Alpha, right? So Alpha issues a certificate of delivery to company B. So we have B here. So certificate of delivery. Company B uses all of the imported graphite to manufacture pencils. So it's manufacturing pencils, and issues a certificate of manufacture and delivery to company D. So company B, manufacturer. So we are talking about the manufacturing direct identification drawback so far. So this is just a reseller. This is graphite. We're talking about the lead, right? The pencil lead. Graphite core. Manufacturer. All right. Let's see. So company D. So to company D, right? Company D is the exporter. So company D, exporter. So the buzzword here is D is automatically eligible as long as they have those chain of custody documents that they are able to demonstrate that from the time it comes to the United States, they're able to demonstrate all those chains of custody which took place. So, but that is a default party. All other parties involved, they have to get assignment rights. They have the company D has to give them the right to claim drawback. So going back to the blank, let's take a look. The blank shall be entitled to claim drawback unless this party, by means certification, assignment. So in other words, what the customs examiners are saying is, who is the default party to get this stuff? So default party based on a chart of direct manufacturing drawback, direct or substitution, is the exporter, right? And the exporter here is the company D. So the company D would be automatically entitled to claim that drawback. Here, the exporter or the company D is the correct answer choice. So C is the right answer for this particular question.